What's good, YouTube? It's your boy, Bluebud Sports TV, back at y'all with another one. So Unified, two-time Unified Heavyweight British World Champion, Anthony Joshua, did a recent interview and break down the highly anticipated title heavyweight rematch between undefeated WBC American Heavyweight World Champion Deontay the Bronze Bomber Wilder and undefeated British Lineal Heavyweight World Champion Tyson the Gypsy King Fury. Anthony Joshua had a lot to say regarding this fight, and he stated that he wanted to fight the winner of this fight, right? He says, but if when it comes down to who he wants to fight, he said, put it this way, you know, if he looking to fight Tyson Fury, he wants Tyson Fury to win and the fight be in the UK. He said, but if Deontay Wilder wins, then the fight will be in the States. He says he don't believe that Tyson Fury will lose this fight. He said he came too close the first time, you know, to lose this fight. He said he fought to a draw. He fought a great fight, and he don't believe that, you know, he'll lose this time going around as he's hungry for it, right? He also stated that he don't believe, and this is where I got confused, right? I was surprised. He says he don't believe that Deontay Wilder has enough power to keep Tyson Fury down. He says at this level, right, when you go up in levels, right, he says Tyson Fury is not dominant Brazil. He said Tyson Fury is not Luis Ortiz. They were never champions. So the fact that they were never champions at this level, this different. The power that you possess won't always come into play when you're dealing with fighters on this level. He says Deontay Wilder has power, but he just doesn't have that much power when dealing with fighters on this level. He won't be able to keep me down, and he won't be able to keep Tyson Fury down. He says, now, you could put him down. He says, you may be able to put me down. You may be able to put Tyson Fury down. He says, but he doesn't have enough power to keep him down. Wow. And he also states that it's vice versa, right? He says that Tyson Fury doesn't have enough power to keep Deontay Wilder down. He could put him down, but he doesn't believe he could keep him down. He definitely don't think that Tyson Fury is going to knock out Deontay Wilder in the second round. He stated that what round did Deontay Wilder knock out Dominic Brazil? He said, I got rid of Dominic Brazil in 7 rounds. He said he got rid of him in 2 rounds. He said 1 and 2 rounds, he stated, but at this level, Dominic Brazil is never a champion. He's not on their level, the three of them, right? He says, so it's going to be very difficult, you know, to put Tyson Fury down and keep him down there because of his will. Now, I understand when they say, you know, your power comes into play when you start to level up with opponents. You know, when you step up in opponents, you know, their will is different, their chin is different, their technique, their experience. It's hard to knock out guys when you step up in competition, right? But with that said, to say that Deontay Wilder, who has arguably the hardest puncher in the history of the sport of boxing, in my opinion, he is. But other people could argue it, right? Some people say Julian Jackson. Some people say George Foreman. Some people say Mike Tyson. Some people, you know, the list goes on and on. Ernie Shavers, right? It's subject to opinion, right? But with that said, in my opinion, I think Deontay Wilder is the hardest puncher the sport of boxing has ever seen. Also, his numbers, his percentage, knockout percentage, resembles that, right? But who am I? That's just my opinion. But with that said, Deontay Wilder has more than enough power to knock Tyson Fury down and keep him down there. Yes, Tyson Fury, I believe in the first fight, was given the benefit of the doubt in that 12th round. As referee Jack Reese stated that he wanted to allow Tyson Fury and give him the benefit of the doubt to get up because he used to be a past champion, right? He was a champion. So he didn't want to just wave it off. And some people agree with it. Some people don't. You get Paulie Malignaggi agrees with it. You get guys like Evander Holyfield that disagrees with it. So everybody's different, right? Some people agree, some people won't, right? At the end of the day, there needs to be rules for referees to be strict across the board. You understand? There shouldn't be no fluctuation in your approach to referee a fight. But that's just the sport of boxing currently. So with that said, Deontay Wilder has proven time and time again that he has more than enough power to knock you down and keep you down. Now, Tyson Fury got up the first time, and he got up the second time. So it's yet to be seen, right? But Deontay Wilder, what needs to be highlighted and needed to be noted is that Deontay Wilder didn't catch Tyson Fury completely clean with the punch he caught Dominique Brazil with. The right hand left hook that he caught Tyson Fury with, the left hook was halfway, right, as he was falling, and the right hand was, it was kind of a check right hand, right? It was on the inside, was like a check right hand. He didn't get full extension on the right hand or the left hook, but yet he still nearly put him out completely, right? He grazed him in the ninth round when he dropped him the first time. He didn't hit him cleanly the first time when he dropped him. So that just goes to show he has more than enough power to knock Tyson Fury out and keep him down, to knock him down and keep him down there. And with that said, you know, Anthony Joshua is chinny. He showed that he's on wobble legs with far less punches when it comes to Deontay Wilder, as well as Tyson Fury. We saw Tyson Fury dropped by Steve Cunningham, and I'm pretty sure nobody's going to confuse Steve Cunningham's power with that of Deontay Wilder's power, right? So I believe I did have to disagree with Anthony Joshua. I think that Deontay Wilder hits and Tyson Fury hit Deontay Wilder very cleanly, very flush. So we see that he was able to withstand Tyson Fury's power, that being Deontay Wilder. Tyson Fury hit Deontay Wilder with flush punches. Those punches that Deontay Wilder knocked Fury down with weren't completely flush. He didn't completely get his full extension on those punches, right? The punch that he hit Luis Ortiz with in the second fight on the forehead was more complete than the punches he landed on Fury. Now, it looked good, the right hand left hook, but it wasn't completely a full extension on him. You understand? The punch that he hit Dominic Brazil and Arthur Spilker with, though he got full punching power, full extension on those punches. And we saw the results. Arthur Spilker looked like he was going to need serious medical attention. And Dominic Brazil was out completely. Luis Ortiz, legs bent underneath his back, right? And he didn't even know what happened. And that was to the forehead, right? So, Bermain Stiverne, he punched through his gloves. So imagine if he gets full extension on the right hand that Tyson Fury doesn't see. Oh, absolutely, he could knock Tyson Fury down and keep him, and he could stay down. But this is a highly anticipated fight. I can't wait to see it. I can't wait to see the winner of this fight Anthony Joshua for Undisputed, point blank and period. And another thing Anthony Joshua said in this interview, Anthony Joshua stated that if he doesn't get Undisputed, he's okay with that, with all the accomplishments he's accomplished in his career. So, see, all of the talk that he must have Undisputed this year in 2020, well, the contradictions are starting to roll in as he's starting to tinker away from fighting Deontay Wilder and Undisputed, right? He don't seem too eager to land the Undisputed bout as he was, you know, coming off that victory against Andrew Ruiz, the rematch. I think that it might have been adrenaline talking. And now he's settled in, and now thinking he's starting to second guess rushing into an Undisputed bout, especially with Deontay Wilder, as he stated that Undisputed is, he wants it, but it's not that important if he don't accomplish it in his career. So that lets you know everything you need to know, point blank and period. But that's all I got for y'all. Y'all already know what it is. It's your boy Blue, Blue Blood Sports TV. Hate, like, comment, and subscribe. If you haven't subscribed, hit the subscribe button. Hit the like button. Hit the bell icon to get all the new notification. Follow me on Instagram at Blue Blood Sports TV, all one word. Y'all already know what it is. Shout out to the entire LDBC. Shout out to New Media. Shout out to Black Media Row. Make sure you like and share these videos. That's all I got for y'all. Peace.